Little People, Big Dreams, Amanda Gorman. Written by Maria Isabel Sanchez Vergara. Illustrated by Queen Bee Monier. Little Amanda lived with her mother and sisters in a two-bedroom apartment in Los Angeles. She had trouble pronouncing some letters, but that didn't stop her from loving words like plum, stone, and spoon. Amanda read everything, from books to cereal boxes. She kept a diary and even tried writing her own dictionary. One day, while listening to her teacher read poetry, Amanda decided to become a poet. Having a speech impediment was a hill to climb for a poet, but Amanda saw it as a gift. Practicing her words with a song full of R's and going to speech therapy made her feel stronger and better. She was a teenager when she set her eyes on a special book. A black girl was staring at her from its cover, and it was written by an African-American woman. Looking at it, Amanda realized that all the books she had read before were written by white men. Discovering books written by authors who looked like her helped Amanda find her own voice. She was the daughter of black writers, descended from freedom fighters who broke their chains and changed the world. The first time she stepped up to the mic was at a poetry workshop. Amanda was worried about how her voice would sound. But once she started performing her poem, she felt that all of her ancestors were right next to her. From the lyrics in a song to the signs of protesters on the streets, she saw poetry everywhere. For Amanda, it was not just a beautiful form of art, but a tool to change the world. She decided to study sociology, the science that explores how humans behave in groups. Amanda was a sophomore in Harvard when she was named America's first youth poet laureate, which led her to perform all around the country. When Joe Biden was chosen to be the next president of the United States, he asked Amanda to read a poem at his swearing-in ceremony. She couldn't wait to run home and tell her twin sister. She was about to follow in the steps of one of her favorite poets, Maya Angelou. The night before, Amanda rehearsed her poem over and over in front of the mirror. The country had lived moments of great division, and she just hoped for two things: bringing a message of unity and not tripping on her way to the podium. The whole world was moved by her poem. Amanda's words invited everyone to lay down their arms and hold hands to build a better country. A country where a skinny black girl could dream of becoming its president. Amanda kept writing about diversity, justice, and equality, things that were bigger than herself. Her books became instant bestsellers, her articles the most read, and her presence a shining light for others. And there will be many more words to add to little Amanda's story, like step, first, and high. Because, as she once wrote, every day we write the future. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe for more videos.